Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In part one of this tutorial, I showed you how to create this dynamic calendar. The calendar is dynamic because it automatically updates based on the criteria selected here. For example, changing the year, changing the month, and changing the day of the week, everything automatically updates. That was part one of this video. I'll leave the link to part one if you haven't seen it already. For part two, we're going to be adding information into this calendar to make it even more useful. Here is the dynamic part of the calendar. What we're going to do now is to add in this task area. Everything we add into this task area, as long as we assign a date, okay, it automatically shows up here. I'm also going to show you two ways to display the information in the calendar. If you look at how the information shows up here, it shows up just how it is written here. I will show you how to also display it with the time included if you want that option, from the earliest task down to the latest task. By the way, this is a template that I sell. If you don't want to go through the hassle of making it, I'll leave a link to my original template. But if you want to go ahead and make this, that's what we're going to cover in today's tutorial. Here's a list of things we're going to do. I'm going to show you how to add the table, how to add this table. We're going to generate the filter formulas. I'll show you how to use the AI assistant instead of just showing you the formula to copy. That way, if you need to tweak something, you can go back into this AI assistant. I'll show you how to do the conditional formatting to show the scratch off effect, as well as the conditional formatting to highlight today's date. It will be a longer video, but as usual, my videos will always be broken down into chapters so you can jump around, pause, come back until you complete the tutorial. I will take the opportunity to say this. If you do like this video, please go ahead and give it a like. It helps my channel be shown to new audiences. Thank you so much in advance for doing that. Now, let's get started with the tutorial. We're going to be starting with this copy. I'll duplicate it, move it over here, and rename it. If you look right here, we only have two columns, okay? And if we go here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So we're going to need to move things around. So first thing we're going to do is add two more columns. Okay. And I'm just going to drag this over here and move these over here. So you can just highlight a bunch of cells together and drag them. All right. And then I'm going to highlight this 4 columns, resize them together so they're about the same size. And then I'm going to separate them. Highlight the columns next to them, merge cell, but don't click on merge cell, click on the arrow, merge horizontal, do the same thing for the next group, merge horizontal, okay? So now we need to add the check boxes here, task, date, and time. Reformat as necessary, especially when you add in new text, it might pick up some weird formatting. All right, I'm just gonna add some borders to this. Change the border color, add a border here. All right, and I'm just gonna add a color to distinguish that header. Okay, and then we can resize this. Just resize it as it makes sense for your specific needs. Obviously, the task would need to be the widest one. Unmerge this and just drag this over here, okay? And now I'm going to go ahead and select the entire column all the way down. We're gonna add some borders. Here's what it looks like. Now, select this column all the way down. Click on insert, checkbox. Make the checkboxes a little bit smaller. And now we're going to change the formatting to make sure that the date picker option shows up when we select each cell. The entire column selected, data, data validation, add rule, is valid dates. And I like to reject the inputs, click done. So now anytime I double click this, the date picker option shows up. And for the time, select the entire column, format, number, go to custom date and time. Scroll all the way down until we see some options for time. So we have a few options here and I'll select this one. You can further customize it by clicking on the individual sections and changing it to what you want. I'm going to keep it the same as is and click apply. So now when I type 9 a.m., I don't need to add any column. I hit enter. It automatically ensures that that formatting is maintained. Now I'm going to copy some dummy data and paste it in here. All right, so now we have some tasks added into our table. Let's start working on the formulas. The first formula is a filter formula. And if you're not going to be using the AI assistant, here is what the formula looks like. You can go ahead and copy it. If you are a member of my Patreon, you will get a copy of this template, this one that says July 2024 that we created today. So you can go ahead and just download it. If you have joined my Patreon, thank you so much for supporting my work. So this part is done. Now we're going to generate the formulas using AI assistance. Okay, for prompting ChatGPT, we need this cell, G6. And we need to tell ChatGPT about this range as well. Here is my ChatGPT account. At the point of creating this video, this model is available for everyone for free. All right, so here is my prompt. I'm asking it to create a formula to allow me filter the data in this range. Okay, where C contains the task, D contains the date, and column E contains the time. I want the task in column C to be filtered when G6 matches the date in D. Let's see what happens when we submit this prompt. So now I'm going to copy this and test it to see if it works. I'm going to paste it right here. We have this error message, obviously, because we don't have this date in the task area. So this is June 30th. So I'm going to change this to June 30th. So now we have the task showing up, but what it's doing, it's crossing over into the date because we do need to change the range. So instead of this being E, let's change this to C because we only want the task to show up instead of the task and the date and the time. And now it works as expected. So let's test out another date. I'm changing this date to June 30th as well. Perfect. So it works. Next, we're going to adjust the formula so that it creates the time in parentheses. Using the updated formula, I'm now asking it to update the formula so that it gives me the part of the formula that adds the time in parentheses. Copy the code back here. First, I'm going to change this from G6 to H6 because we're using Monday instead of Sunday. So we need to change the location of where the date is being referenced from. So H6, which is right here, and click enter. And now let's see. All right, so we're getting this error message. So I'm going to go ahead and copy it, take it back to ChatGPT and see if we can figure out what the problem is. All I did was paste the error message. And now I'm going to copy the updated formula to see if that works. Here's what it looks like. The formatting might be off. So what I'm going to do is copy this and go back to ChatGPT. I said, this is what the result is showing up as. This is what I wanted to show up as. All right. And then it gave me an updated formula. So I'm going to copy this. All right. We're going to delete that. Okay. And now we're going to paste it here. All right. And here's what it's looking like. So client follow up July 1st. Let's see where that shows up on our table. Client follow up right here at 4 p.m. So it is working how we want. We're going to need to fix these formulas so that we can copy it throughout the rest of the table. For example, for it to take this and copy it here, it doesn't work. Everything moves. As you can see, this moves here, this moves here, and this moves over here. So we're going to fix the formula so that we can easily copy and paste them. All right. And to do this, we need to add dollar signs basically before each of the columns. On my MacBook, all I need to do is click right here and click F4, and it does it automatically. You can do this manually. Just type in the dollar sign before the column, before the row. I'm going to add it everywhere except for the date. So now we have it everywhere. And finally, what I want to do last is to add an if error. If there is no data, I don't want it to show an error message. I want it to show blank. For example, if I were to change this date right here from the 1st of July to August 1st. Okay, here's what happens here. The formula is fine, but it shows this error message because there is no entry for that specific date. I don't want that to show up like this. I want it to be clean. So we're going to start by clicking right before the formula after the equal sign. We're going to type if error. Okay, now we're going to do open parentheses, go all the way to the end, comma, and then you can do space or you can do no data. So now we're going to do two quotations and close the formula with another parenthesis and enter. And now it's blank. If you wanted to say something, what you can do then is go back to the formula and instead of having the two quotation, you can type whatever you want as long as it's typed within the quotation. So you can type no task and enter and it shows up like this. Okay. So whatever message you want, you can type it or just leave it blank and take the text out. Just make sure there's nothing between the quotations and hit enter. If you want to use the basic formula, you're going to do the same thing. Add dollar signs to lock the formulas, then add if error. Okay, so now you have both options. For the rest of this tutorial, I will be using the second formula option. So now I'm going to go ahead and copy this formula. Okay, I'm just copying the cell. It copies the formula and paste it right here. And just to show you that it's working correctly, if I double click on this, you can see that the right columns are selected and the right cell above the row is selected. So I'm going to go ahead and keep pasting, paste. And now I'm going to do the same here. So now that I've pasted it for the entire row, what I'm going to do to save time is I'm going to copy all of this, go to the next week, paste, the next week, paste, the next week, paste, the next week, paste. And now I'm going to do a little bit of reformatting to make sure it still looks okay. You can either wrap the text or you can use the clip option. And then just copy the formatting from here using the paint format and just paste it in the next week and just repeat the steps for the entire calendar. Okay. And then what you can actually do is increase the size of the rows so the task is easier to read. So I'm selecting all of them, resize rows, change it to 35. That way, if it wraps into two lines, like we can see in this example right here, we can still read it without a problem. All right, so let's double check a few of them. July 8th, we have an event at 1 p.m. and at 2 p.m. So let's go to July 8th. So we have one here at 1 p.m. That's right here. And the other one, July 8th, right here is at 2 p.m. Okay, so that works. What if we change this to 7 a.m.? Okay, I'm going to change it to 7 a.m. And let's go back here. And it changes the time here and it resorts it in the right sort order. The formulas work as they should. So we'll cross that out. Next, we're going to do the scratch off effect, which is exactly what I just did here. Okay, so when I check this off, it crosses it off here. Okay, so we're going to go back, select this entire column range. Okay, because we want to apply the conditional formatting here. Format, conditional formatting, or you can select any of these two. Conditional formatting is also right there. Click on conditional formatting. And right now it's changing everything to green because this is the range we selected. Now we're going to click on format rules, custom formula, and in custom formula, click equals, type B7. B7 is the first cell with a checkbox. B7 is true, meaning if it's checked off. And now we want the color to be none. We want to change the color of the text when it's crossed off to be like a light gray color. And we want the strike through option selected. Let's test it out. It doesn't work. So let's edit this. Add the dollar symbol before the B7 and done. All right. And as you can see, it works fine. Okay. So just don't forget to add the dollar symbol before the column. And that part is done. And the last conditional formatting I want to show you is to highlight today's date. To do this, we're going to select the calendar because we want to make sure all the dates are included. So just select it like so. We have conditional formatting showing up here. So click and add another rule. Under format rules, select date is today and change the color to whatever you want. So let's say I want the today's date to show up as red and click done. And there you go. So today is the 9th of July and it shows up as 9th of July. If you open up this template, the 10th of July, the 10th of July will be highlighted. If you're still here watching all the way till the end, as a bonus, I'm going to give you an additional tip. We can add an additional criteria such that when we check off a task, it disappears. It doesn't show up in our calendar. Here is the updated formula. So now I'm going to delete the formula that we're currently using right here. Okay. I'm going to delete that. I'm going to add this formula. Okay. This has an additional criteria that will look at column B and it's going to look for a check mark. If this is checked, so meaning this is true, it will remove this task from the calendar. Let's test it out. So I have pasted the updated formula here, click on enter. And right now let's check off this task. This task is July 2nd right here and just cross it off. And as we do that, it doesn't show up anymore. Okay. So now what we can do is I'm leaving this here. So you have the option of using this version. Okay. So I'm not going to change it for this cell. Copy the formula. I'm going to paste it here and just delete the rest of the formulas. Okay. And just paste them. Then do the same thing here. Paste the formulas here as well. Copy the formula for the entire week and paste them here. Here. So it's not going to look different until we start crossing things off. All right, here's what it's looking like. I'm just readjusting the formatting because we did lose some borders with the copying and pasting. All right, so it looks exactly the same, but it will start to change when we start crossing things off. So let's cross out a bunch of things from the table. And as we cross things off, I'll make this a little bit smaller so you can see more within the calendar. And as we cross things off, look what happens. They begin to disappear from the calendar. Okay. And let's just cross everything off. Nothing shows up in the calendar. And if we uncheck them, they begin to reappear back into the template. Like I said before, if you are a member of my Patreon, you will get this July 2024 template. If you're not a member of my Patreon, no worries. Go ahead, pause the video. Here's a formula. Copy it and use it for your own template. Thank you so much for watching. If you learned something new, give me a like. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. And any questions that you have, things that you want me to test out, new template videos that you want me to create, leave them in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.